Hey everyone, Ralph here. One of the most common questions or requests that you guys have had in the past 2 weeks is how to programmatically upload files to your assistants using the OpenAI Assistants API. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how easy it is to do with a few lines of code in Node.js. So let's get into it. So I have two windows open. I have VS Code and a terminal, and all of the code that we're going to be walking through here today is available in a link in the video description, along with a few steps of how to set this up. So make sure to go grab that in the video description. Before I explain the code, I want to show you how it works in action. So I'm going to be running this code in my terminal here. So it's just node run assistant.js. And what we're going to be doing is creating an assistant that is a murder mystery helper, and then upload a file that contains the murder name. And what we're doing here is just hit this, and I've set it up in a way that if I don't already have an assistant, it's going to create one, but I'm saving the assistant information in this assistant.json file. So if I run this code again, we will be reusing an existing assistant, so you don't have to create one over and over and over again. But back to this. So what we're being asked here by the script is, what is it that you want to do? Do you want to, one, chat with the assistant, or two, upload a file? So let's just fast forward to the file. We're going to be selecting two. Enter your choice. Number two, enter the file name to upload. So I have this clues.txt that contain the name of the murderer. So let's say clues.txt. And what the script does is that it uploads it to OpenAI and then attaches it to our assistant. So now our assistant actually has a file that it can use. So let's go ahead and try it. So do we want to perform another action? Yes. And I want to chat with the assistant, so I'm going to press one. And what is your question? Let's just jump to it. Who's the killer? And without the file, it would have no clue what the killer is, but now it knows that it's Rick Sanchez, because that's what clues.txt tells it. So let's just exit all of this and walk you through it, and I'll run it again at the end of the script, or sorry, end of the tutorial, just to show you how it works with uploading several files and reusing this assistant.json. If you're mainly interested in the file upload bit and you've already used Assistance API before, check a timestamp or a chapter in the video to skip ahead to that portion. But for everyone that is new to Assistance API, I figured I'll just explain all of the code in here. So we are importing a couple of dependencies here, and all of these again are available and explained in a link in the video description. But we're using .env because we're storing our OpenAI API key as an environment variable here. We're using the OpenAI npm package. I'm using fs to read and write files, such as the assistant file, the clues.txts, etc. And then we're using readline to allow us to do this back and forth between the user and the script. We're setting up an OpenAI connection right here, reading the OpenAI API key from this environment variable that we created here. And then we just have this ask question function where we're using readline to get input. And then the meat of all of this lives in this main function. So I'll walk through that, but I just sort of want to mention that this gets called at the very end, and this is what allows us to keep talking to the script as we go. So this main function will continuously run until we exit the script. And what it does is that it just starts with setting this assistant ID as an empty variable. And then we're going to be having this assistant file path that we say is assistant.json. And what I used assistant.json for, again, is just storing if we have an existing assistant. We're going to store the information in that so we can reuse that, so we don't create a new assistant every time we run this script. So what we're doing is just checking, does that already exist? If so, let's use it. If it doesn't exist, let's go ahead and create an assistant with the OpenAI API and then store that in a file and continue to use that. So that's what we're just doing right here. Starting with checking, we're doing a try here, checking if we can read this file. If it doesn't exist, it will error and we'll go here. But if the file exists, we're just going to go ahead and read all of this data, store it in assistant details. We're going to read this assistant ID and store it in the placeholder that we just created. And we're just going to fetch it from right here. And this is what we get back from the OpenAI API if we create an assistant. So we need that later when we call the OpenAI API to create conversations and files essentially. And then we just log and say, hey, we have an existing assistant, let's use that. But again, like the first time I ran this script, we didn't have an assistant. So we're just gonna say, okay, no existing assistant detected, creating a new one. So that's what you can see right here. And then we're creating a config variable where we're storing the inputs that we wanna send to the OpenAI assistant creation endpoint. So it's the name of our assistant. I name mine Murder Mystery Helper. Instructions is you're a murder mystery assistant helping solve murder mysteries. You can change these, obviously. Then for tools, I'm here only giving it the retrieval tool. This is required if you want it to read files that you give it. So you at least have to have this, but you can add code interpreter and browsing as an example. And then model is just which model is going to use. And right now, I think the only one that exists is this GPT-4 1106 preview. And then we're gonna send an API call to OpenAI to create this assistant. So we're just gonna const assistant and make it await.openai.beta.assistance.create. And we're just passing in this assistant config, which is everything that OpenAI needs to create an assistant. And then we're creating this assistant details variable that includes the assistant config and assistant ID right here. And then what we're doing with that is just creating this assistant.json file right here. So we have it for future use. And then lastly, we just set the assistant ID to the assistant ID that we got back from OpenAI and which is also stored in our JSON because we need it later. So now we either use an existing assistant or we created one. Now we can go ahead and start using it. So what the script does is just say, hello there, I'm your personal assistant. You gave me these instructions. So this is what you can see right here. And then we go ahead and create a thread. And what that is in OpenAI is an assistant can have several threads. And you can think about threads as conversations. One assistant can have several threads or several conversations. And each conversation can have several messages. So think about messages as you asking something, you get a response from the assistant, you ask something, you get a response, and all of those sort of back and forth are stored in one thread. So what we're creating here is just a new thread with the assistant that we're now going to start fill up with questions and answers. And in order to have this ongoing conversation in our script here, we're going to be using a while loop that will continue so long as this keep asking is set to true. And it's set by true to true by default here. So that means that we're going to run this while loop. And this while loop is going to start off by asking, what do you want to do? You want to one, chat with the assistant, or two, upload a file. So it's what you can see here. And then the user needs to input their choice, either one or two. And I don't have any error handling around anyone saying three or anything else. So you can add that if you want. Now, if action is two, we're going to start uploading a file. And that's probably why most of you came to this video. So we're asking this, enter the file name to upload. And we're storing that file name in this file name variable. Now, I assume that the file exists in the same folder as your script, and assume that the file also exists. If you provide a non-existing file name, there's no error handling for that. So that might be something that you want to add to your script if someone else other than yourself are using it. So We're going to take this file name and then we're going to upload that file to OpenAI. So what we do here is that we const the file, we use the openai.files.create endpoint. We're passing in the file here, and then we have to set this purpose parameter to assistants. You have to do that, or otherwise your assistant won't be able to use the file. Next, what we're doing is that we need to tell OpenAI that this file that I just uploaded, I want this assistant, my assistant, to have access to it. And we're doing that by updating our assistant. So we're going to call this openai.beta.assistants.update. We're passing in the assistant's ID of the assistant that we're using, and then we're passing in our file ID. And we actually need to not just pass in our one file ID, because let's assume that we have uploaded historical files. If you just pass in the file ID right here, you're going to be overriding other files and just say this assistant only has this file ID that I created. So what I'm doing here is that I'm also passing in any existing files. So I'm passing in the new file ID and any previous files that I've uploaded via my script. And the way that I have this existing file IDs here is that I store all file IDs that I upload in the assistant JSON. So when I uploaded the clues.txt here, I got an ID back. I stored it in this assistant JSON. So next time I go ahead and upload a file, which I'll do in a minute, we're passing in this existing ID along with the new ID to make sure that OpenAI has an array of all the file IDs. Again, if you only send this, you're going to be overriding existing file IDs and only use one file. So that's what we're doing right here. So now our assistant has this file attached to it, and I'll show you what this looks like in the OpenAI portal as well. And then lastly, we're just updating our file here to make sure that we're storing this file ID that we get back from the OpenAI API in our file. Once we've done that, we just console log this file uploaded and successfully added to assistant. So for anyone that wants to upload files to assistants, this is really what you need to know. It's really that simple. Assistants.update and the file ID. Now, if you are new to the Assistants API, I'm just going to show you the rest of the script here, if that's something that is useful. Now, we're just asking again, do you want to take another action? I said yes right here. We then select chat with assistant. And by doing that, we choose action one. And then we're just going to continue asking here. So we ask, what is your question? And now we get back to the thread or the threads. So we have created a thread previously. We've stored the thread ID here in the thread.id. And now we're going to be sending our user question to OpenAI. So I asked, who is the killer? That gets stored in this user question. We're passing that into the openai.beta.threads.messages.create, passing in the thread ID, the role, which is the user, and the user's question. And then the way that OpenAI's assistance API works is that you don't just get a response back similar to the chat completion endpoint if you use that. You have to create what's called a run, because this is going to run in the background and you're not going to be told when the answer is ready. You actually have to do some polling. So the way that that works is that you create what's called a run, you pass in the thread ID, you pass in which assistant that should be getting this, and then this run gets triggered in OpenAI's backend. And now you have to start asking, is this done yet? Is this done yet? Do you have an answer for me? So we set up a run status here where we're calling openai.beta.threads.run, and we're trying to retrieve the status of this run. Is it completed yet? When we run this the first time, it's going to be no, it's not completed, because it's just been a millisecond since you send the or created this run, so OpenAI can start sort of processing your question. So we set up this polling mechanism. So while run status is different than completed, we're essentially going to be every once a second, we're going to check is the runs check what the run status is by trying to retrieve it for this thread ID and run ID. And there are other statuses than just completed. It can either be completed, failed, canceled, or expired. So we just make sure that we also look for those. And if either of those happen, we're just going to break and go back and ask you to provide another question. But once the run status is completed, we now have an answer. So we're going to fetch that using the openai.beta.threads.messages, and we're going to get a list for the thread ID. So again, a thread can include several different messages. If you ask several questions, you're going to have all of those, and they're all provided to you in the API response, so you don't have to keep state of previous questions. But we only want to show the answer to the most recent question, so we don't need all of that. So in this little script right here, we're just fetching the most recent assistant answer. We don't care about previous answers. We don't care about the user question. We already have it here. We just want the answer to the most recent question or the message. So we just fetch that here. And then we just go ahead and provide it as a console.log right here. And then once that is done, we're just going to ask, do you want to ask another question? And you can say yes or no. If it's yes, you just ask another question. If it's no, we pop down to the level above, which is, do you want to perform another action? Do you want to upload a file? Do you want to chat? If that's no, we just exit the script. And that's all of it right here. So let me show you once again how this works, and then we'll just look at what this looks like in the OpenAI platform as well. So I'm going to go ahead and run Node Run Assistant again. And you can see the difference here. It says existing assistant detected, because now we created one previously, so we're going to be using that. We're not creating a new assistant. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and upload a file again just to show you something. So I'm going to upload the same file. I'm going to upload clues.txt. And you might say, well, you already did that. Like, will that work? Yes. And here's an important point. This will work. It will upload it. And OpenAI doesn't really keep track of like, hey, this is the same content that you provided to me previously. It doesn't really care about that. So I'm going to flip over to my browser here. We have a list of assistants. So here's the murder mystery helper that we created moments ago. If I open this, you can see that it actually has two files, and it's currently showing the IDs. The names will load in a minute. And that's because it doesn't keep track again. Like, both of them are called clues.txt. They have the same contents because on our computer, it's the same file. But OpenAI doesn't understand that. We have just uploaded two different files and said those two files should be used by this assistant. So that's worth noting, that you can upload the same file several times and OpenAI won't give you an error. And if you ever want to clean up assistants, you can just go ahead and delete them. By clicking the three dots and hitting delete here. And similarly, any files that you have uploaded, you can do this programmatically. It's not in scope of this tutorial, but you can just head over to files here. You can see we have two clues.txt that were uploaded a few minutes in between. And this allows us to delete them if we want to. But that's it for this tutorial. Now you know how to upload files to OpenAI programmatically and how to give assistants access to use those files. I hope that this was a useful starting point for you. If it was, please consider giving this video a thumbs up and also consider subscribing to the channel. I will be putting out a lot more OpenAI tutorials in the future. But thank you for watching this one, and maybe I will see you in a future video. Bye.